Hi. For this final week, we want to propose you a challenge. Can you program the robot in our factory to pick an object from the conveyor belt? For example, this box. This is what is called a picking application, and it's a very typical task in robotics. Here is another example of picking application. This is the robotic system we developed at TU-Delft to win the Amazon Robotics Challenge in 2016, in collaboration with the company Fisir. The challenge consisted of a complex case of picking in an Amazon warehouse. The robot has to find the target product in a cluttered bin, solve the manipulation problem to grasp it by planning all the motions required and synchronize their execution with the activation of the gripper, and finally move to store the product in the Amazon shelf, which is not visible in this shot. As you have seen, the robot needs to perform a coordinated series of actions to solve the task. In previous weeks, you have learned to program some of the individual actions needed in such tasks using the capabilities provided by available ROS packages. For example, the MoveIt library and its MoveGroup node for manipulation with a robot arm. You have also learned how you can implement new robot capabilities in ROS by programming ROS publishers or servers of services or ROS actions. In this final week, we are going to learn to put these capabilities together and create a ROS system that solves a complete task. We are going to design and implement a robot behavior in ROS. So, in this week, we'll learn how we can create a robot behavior using state machines. And we are going to use the FlexBee tool to implement them in ROS. FlexBee has been developed by Philip Schillinger, who also maintains it. FlexBee provides a visual interface for developing and executing robot behaviors in ROS. But it also includes many more interesting features. For example, there are many FlexBee states available, which allow you to directly use standard capabilities in ROS inside your state machines. We will learn how to use and configure them to implement a state machine for the picking behavior in our factory. However, sometimes we need a new capability that is specific to our robot application, and a FlexBee state for it doesn't exist yet. We will address this situation in the last module of the week, when we will learn to program a simple FlexBee state, and we will use that state in our state machine. Finally, this week we'll finish with a very special assignment, the final project of the course. It consists of integrating a complete robotic system for our factory, using all that you have learned during the course. During the week, we will be showing you how to use FlexBee to integrate a simple pick behavior. With it, we will be able to pick an object from the conveyor belt with the robot. Now, the challenge we are proposing you in the final project of the course is to extend that behavior to completely robotize the factory. Remember that in our factory, the parts should be delivered to the container next to the second robot. So, to transport them there, you will need to extend the behavior so that after robot one picks a part, it places that part on the turtle bot, which then has to navigate to take it to robot two. Finally, robot two has to pick the part from the turtle bot and place it in the final container. Does this seem complex to you? It is indeed. But once you have completed this week, you will realize that you can actually do it if you put in practice all that you have learned during the course. So let's get started.